Hi all and welcome back to the channel, and I hope you're all doing okay. Should be quite a quick video because I've only got a little bit to cover tonight. I did want to cover the Fernando Alonso and Sergio Perez accidents in FP3, but unfortunately every time I use Formula One content videos on my channel, I just end up with copyright issues, so I kind of gave up and couldn't be bothered. Kind of wondering if that's what their problem was in qualifying, because both Perez and Alonso did really struggle, so maybe the setup, right, they didn't have the time to do it, who knows, but certainly on for a fascinating race tomorrow. Right, so let's start off with Valtteri Bottas, because he has reportedly held a 15-minute meeting with Williams team principal James Vowles in the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix paddock. Bottas is out of contract at the end of the season and is unlikely to be offered a new deal by Sauber following a difficult season so far. And obviously, of course, with the signing of Nico Hülkenberg, and I believe Audi is still waiting for a decision from Carlos Sainz, but there's no room for him there. But I did just want to say that I remember when Bottas was at Williams, and I remember seeing him then, and much like George, I think I've said it before on my channel, that to me they really did drive the wheels off that car. And they were delivering some good results. But the problem is, yeah, going back to Williams, it may suit Bottas, it may suit Williams, and they've got an experienced driver in the car alongside Alex Albon, who's doing a phenomenal job. But the car characteristics will take some getting used to again, because it's going to be nothing like it was before. So I would be interested to see him go back to Williams. Whether he will or not, only time will tell. Then I want to move on to Kimi Antonelli, because he could be the one Toto Wolff has in mind to replace Lewis Hamilton next year, in what is believed to be Wolff's biggest hint so far. In response to questions by Sky Sports F1 team about Hamilton's incredible reception in Italy ahead of his move to Ferrari, Wolff responded, "We will get used to the outfits, but we've got to look at ourselves. And you know, maybe there's an option that we shine more with an Italian in our car." And I'm still unsure about putting somebody who's not got massive amounts of experience in a car, which, by the way, that Toto Wolff has said within the next 3 to 4 weeks, James Allison believes that the car is going to be radically different in the sense that it's going to be more competitive. So that's quite an interesting one to watch. So maybe they'll give Antonelli a private test then and see how he does. And then I want to finish up with Aston Martin's Lance Stroll, because he's been defended by team principal Mike Crack, who hit back at recent comments that Stroll has received. Crack was told that Stroll had been seen as the least secure driver of the top 5 teams, with other teams viewing him as someone who could drop out of the points on Sunday. Crack said, "This is disrespectful in my opinion, and unfair too. If you look at his development in recent years, he handled the duel with Sebastian Vettel well. He has also done well against Fernando Alonso. We do still need to get a bit more consistency. We need to work on that, but I find that statement disrespectful, even if in an environment like Formula One, I can understand it." I think they really do need to evaluate Stroll, and I'm not saying he's a bad driver, because sometimes he's had some pretty good, astonishing results. But yeah, I think Mike Crack was right there where he said the consistency is an issue and they need to get on top of that. Once they do, maybe things will improve. And I just wanted to mention that Oscar Piastri will not start second tomorrow. He will start from fifth, after the stewards decided that he had impeded Kevin Magnussen during qualifying. So he got Max on pole, followed by Lando Norris, Charles Leclerc, Carlos Sainz and Oscar Piastri. So it would have been nice to see two McLarens challenging Max off the line, to be honest, but it's not going to happen. So poor old Lando is going to have to struggle trying to take on Max and defend against Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz. So that'll be an interesting one to watch. But that's all I've got for you this evening. Sorry it's a short video, but there's not really a lot going on. So anyway, hope you enjoy the race tomorrow. Hopefully I'll have another video out tomorrow night. But as always, thank you so much indeed for your comments, your likes and your shares. And hello to my new subscribers and of course my old subscribers. I really and truly do appreciate you all, and thank you so much for being here with me. And of course, if you do like what I do, please consider pressing the like button. Also press the subscribe button and also press the notification bell so you get those all important future warnings of my uploads. And as always, until the next time, take care.